He finally told you?
No, he never mentioned you, but I've known about you for a while.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm surprised I haven't heard from you sooner.
Well, it's not really my style, but since you were in the vicinity, I thought I'd introduce myself.
Look, Mrs. Haynes, I am really sorry for what this has done to you, and I know Stephen never meant to hurt you.
Well, yeah, you don't know anything about my husband.
I do know that a woman never steals another woman's husband. They usually go willingly.
Sounds like you have a lot of experience in that area. No, Stephen is a very smart man. He's just way too smart to take someone like you seriously. I mean...
Mrs. Haynes, I know so many women like you. You have your fancy friends and your nice houses, and your calendars are full of social events and shopping dates and charity lunches to make you feel like you're actually doing something with your lives. But eventually you stop paying attention to your men. They get lonely, and they come looking for someone who makes them feel appreciated again. And believe me, they take that very, very seriously.
You know, I came in here with, I admit, just a ridiculous idea. That if you and I ever met and you saw that I was an actual human being, and not just some stray thought out in Connecticut, that you might actually feel a little bit of remorse, you know? One woman having that transcendent moment of connect with another. And that you might realize the scope of the damage that you've done, not just to me, but to a family.
I have no idea what you just said.
I know, yeah, so I'm gonna put this in terms that even you can understand. You are gonna stop seeing my husband.
I guess that's up to him, isn't it?
Listen, let me give you a little bit of a tip. Stephen... Stephen would never like anything that, trashy.
Well, if Stephen doesn't like anything I'm wearing, I take it off.
You were great, Mary.
Get me out of here.
Too fast. Live now before the moment